It's Debbie here, and it's March already. I can't believe that it's been a whole month since I did the first video for the year. Oh, things have just got in the way, you know. I've been so busy with my books. I've written so many. I was talking to a friend just a minute ago on Skype, and he said, "What have you been doing lately?" And I just wrote him a great big list of all the things that I've been doing, and I thought, man, I didn't realize I'd been so productive. And so it hasn't all been a waste of time with these damaged ribs, because I've been able to sit quietly and just write to my heart's content. And I have nearly finished another couple of books, and I'm really excited about it. So what I have to do now is to concentrate on getting that PayPal account back. And so that will have to be my next few days' mission. I have written to them, and I am expecting a reply from them, but whether they will reply in the time frame they said, I'm not sure. But that's okay, we all continue on. I mean, it's not as though I've given up altogether. And I know that PayPal would be the best way, because everybody seems to have PayPal, and really, I don't know how I'm managing really without it, because that used to be my only form of payment on the internet anyway. And of course, it's meant a lot of lost business for me. But sometimes things are sent to you as angels in disguise. And so we just have to buckle up and think, okay, what can we learn from this and go from there? All right, well, it's my 30-year anniversary today. Yes, Keith and I have been married for 30 years. I can't believe that we've lasted this long, because we have had our moments. I think all married couples have their moments, and you've got to choose how you're going to handle those moments. There have been some moments when I've really wanted to think, no, that's the end of it. And he's probably been the same, but anyway, he stuck it out with me and I stuck it out with him. We've worked through whatever we had at the time, which was a problem, which probably was nothing really. It just meant we had to talk to each other about something, and I had to get the courage up to talk to him, because he has always been a dominant person, and I was a wee bit frightened to talk to him earlier in our marriage. But now I've got courage, and we do talk, and it's amazing how I think he's thinking something and he's not thinking that at all, and the same about me. And so really, that's really what is at the root of many marriages' problems, because you don't talk about things and you think something's happening and it's not, or you think it's not happening and it is, and you don't really get down to the bottom of whatever it is bothering you. And so if you don't bother to find out, well, that's when you're in a lot of trouble. And you know, our children look to us. I mean, I remember my daughter-in-law sending me a little text one time to say, "Mum, we look to you for an example. How are you managing with this? You know, me and your son sorted out like this. So do you think you could help? That might help you with Dad." Anyway, I talked to him about it and took her advice. Hey, and it worked. So, you know, you can learn from your kids as well. Don't think that they don't know anything, because they do. And they have a different approach to life to what we've had, because we've been raised differently. And so sometimes it pays to listen to them, you know. Anyway, so now we're into the next generation of marriages, because one of my granddaughters got married, and she's been married a whole year already. And they have one little boy. And they have another one coming, but this new one, he's being a little bit naughty. Well, we don't know if it's a he or a she, because it's threatening miscarriage and has taken its mother through to the hospital so many times these past few weeks. And we've all been really worrying and praying, and I've put a name on the prayer roll, all of our names on the prayer roll, so that we can give her strength without worrying her more than what she's worried at the moment. And that little monkey, you know, the mum goes off to her scans, and the little monkey waves at his mother. Just waves. It just has this little hand that goes like this. And she said, "I'm square, it's grinning," but of course you can't really see that. And she said, and "I want to know what it is." And guess what? It closes its legs. Or it just turns over and goes ho-hum and turns his back to his mother. I mean, honestly, Now, isn't that just amazing that even in the womb they have their own little personalities? Now, if it does decide to stay with us, it's going to have so many names, because one that I can think of is he's cheeky, and another one he's got going to know be known by me as is stubborn, and the other one is modest. And I'm thinking, well, maybe it's a little girl because it's being so modest. But then when it turns its back to its mother, I think, well, maybe it's not a little girl. Maybe it's just being smart, you know, before it even comes out. You don't want your children to be like that before they even come out. I mean, really, it's hard enough handling them when they come. And so it's going to be very, very interesting experience over these next few months. It's not due till September, so we've got a long way to go yet. And you will have seen my blanket that I knitted for it. I did that in 3 weeks because, you know, I felt driven to knit it. And I don't know why. And then next thing I know, she was in hospital and I thought, oh, and I only had a little bit to do to finish it off. And so I did finish it off and I sent it up to my daughter and she's put it away so that if anything happens, they've got something there for the baby. And then I thought, well, it needs little soft white clothes, you know, like newborns. And then in my day, they had little soft white things, you know. And so I send little soft white things. I don't worry about these coloured things that everybody puts on them nowadays, because I just like a little newborn baby to be a new born little baby. And so I sent a little hat and I sent a little wee singlet, you know, and I sent little mittens and booties. So that would have something really nice and soft to come home in, whether it comes home as a stillborn or as if it comes home as a new little baby into our family. And so I sent that, and now at the moment I am attempting, I'm saying attempting because I haven't crocheted for a long time, I am going around the edges of muslin wraps. I don't know if they even use muslin wraps nowadays, but we used to use these things. Well, we used to use a whole nappy, but nowadays, you know, muslin wraps seem to be the thing. Well, I hope they still are. And so I'm crocheting around the edge and just making it a little bit more personal for the baby so she can have something nice and soft to wrap it up. And then she's got that lovely blanket that I've knitted for it as well. And so I'm really looking forward to this new addition to our family, and I hope it does decide to stay with us. But of course you can't tell. My granddaughter does have something internally wrong with her, and so it may not stay with us. And so we've got to accept that and just hope and pray that she can get through whatever week she is able to carry it anyway. But anyway, that's what's happening in our family. And this is March, and today it's my anniversary, as I told you. And in 4 days' time, it's my husband's birthday. Now, he planned that when we got married. He planned that if he had our wedding just before his birthday, he would never forget our wedding anniversary. You know, it's very important for men to remember these things without their children reminding them, did you remember that it's your anniversary tomorrow so you can say something to mum? I meet so many people who do that to their parents. Makes me laugh, you know, because my children often forget, and so we're the ones that have to remind them. Well, it's our turn at the moment. But anyway, so it's his birthday on Saturday, so that'll be nice. He will be home because at the moment he's working in Wellington, so he's not home today for our anniversary, but that's fine because I've had a wonderful day. He rang me at 4 o'clock when he was driving to work, just on the way to driving to work, and to wish me happy anniversary. Wasn't that nice? And then what did I do after Tai Chi? I decided, oh, I'm going to go to the movies. I haven't been able to go to the movies since I had this rib problem, and I've missed so many movies. And on Tuesdays you can get a special price, so I've always gone in the past on a Tuesday and kept up with all the movies that are coming out, because we have a very modern Picton theatre that brings new movies in very quickly. And so I went to see the Great Wall today, which was a historic story about the Great Wall of China. And it was based on a legend that they've had about the Great Wall for many years. And I really enjoyed it, you know. I didn't realise it's as big as it is. I mean, you talk about the Great Wall of China and you see it on pictures, but until you actually, excuse me, until you actually see it like I did in the movie. I would never have known it was like that. And of course, I'm not sure if I'll ever get to go and see it myself. So I was really thrilled to see this movie. And I'm very thrilled that whoever wrote the story was very good of them to do that so that I could see it. And so that's what I did. And then when I came out of the movies, what did I do? Oh, that's right. I went off and bought a Subway for lunch because I thought, well, if my husband was home, we'd go out for dinner. And so because I like to have my hot meal in the daytime, I thought, well, I'll go and get a Subway, took it up, brought it home to eat. And then I thought, well, I like dessert. I'm really into desserts, you know. So I went to the local ice cream parlor and they weren't open because I was going to get myself a lovely banana, you know, one of those banana sundae things. And they weren't open. And so I thought, well, I'll go up to the supermarket, and I love Viennetta ice cream, and we don't buy that very much because it's a bit expensive. And anyway, I thought, no, I'm going to have some. So I bought, you know, it's only about that big. And so I brought it home and had that after my Subway lunch, and I've had a wonderful day. I've had a wonderful day, and now I'm doing this video and telling you all about my day today, and I'm really enjoying myself. And so that is how today is running along for me. I've also added a few chapters to a couple books. I've talked to people. I've done some more research on the other things that I'm looking at doing. And I've had people give me advice and add to things that I'm doing. And it's been wonderful, really. And I'm really excited about it. Anyway, so I can see that this video is getting up to 12 minutes already. And I'm thinking, well, is there anything else I want to tell you except that my ribs are not quite healed, but I am able to go back to Tai Chi, which I have been doing these past few days. And today, our Grand Senior Master was looking around to grade us all. He graded many of them last week, and there were a couple of us still left to be graded, and he was watching us today. So let's hope I did the right things. I have missed a lot, and I've missed the new moves, and I'm thinking, oh gosh, that's going to hold me up for it again, because last time they did the grading I got cramp in my toes and had to come home. So that wasn't very pleasant, because I didn't know they were doing grading, otherwise I might have forced my toes to cooperate. Anyway, I went home and, you know, had the salt, and then I had to spend the rest of the day in bed because I was so exhausted from this terrible, terrible cramp that I suffer sometimes. And the next couple of weeks I found out they'd all been graded and I'd missed. And so I had to remain in the learner's class this past 6 months. And I don't mind that I've had to, because it helps you to make sure you do the moves correctly, because you're constantly going over the new moves with the new people. And so I'm able to keep up with them and then refine what I'm doing. And I'm not rushing through it, and I'm actually probably doing it far better than I was if I had been graded and just went on to the new stuff. So I'm quite happy with myself. And he said last week that he would watch us today over this week, and to include us in the grading this time. And so there's two of us left. He watched us today, and I'm thinking, oh gosh, I hope I did it right. I felt that I had done it right, so that's all I can do. And I will just have to give you the results when they come out. So that's exciting for me. The weather's been wintry, and then it's summery, and then the whole of the North Island, up the top of the North Island, has been under huge flood conditions. Our poor daughter is even short of water and their house is flooded. That's just amazing to me. And here we are in Picton expecting the rain, and we've had a few puddles, not very many. We've had a few downpours, but not torrential. And the river hasn't risen, which is usually a sign of torrential rain. We haven't had anything like the top of the North Island has experienced. And so I'm really happy that we've been down here, because the weather's so mild. I mean, we live inside our valley, and so maybe the weather bounces off us. I'm not sure. I'm not a weatherman, so I don't really know. And so I'm happy with our living conditions at the moment anyway, because I thought, oh gosh, if we get that torrential rain, we're going to have to move the bus onto the stones so that we don't sink like we do in the winter. And so we haven't had to do that, so that's cool. And Keith's not here, and so who would drive it for me? But anyway, that's all right. We get things sorted even when he is in Wellington. Sometimes if he has to do something, he catches the boat after his shift, comes in quicks, he fixes it up and then goes straight back on the next one. And so I'm very, very lucky, really. He does spoil me. I am spoiled. And I'm happy to have my 30th anniversary today. And I'm happy with the man that I have who looks after me. And I try my best to look after him. And let's hope that we can keep going together for as long as whatever life that we're allowed to have here on this earth. He's had his scare with his cancer, and I've had my scare that's not activated yet with my myeloma. And so we sort of live every day thinking, well, we're okay today, let's go and do something. And so that's how we have to live. That's life, huh? Anyway, I'm going to say goodbye now, because now we're over 15 minutes and we're nearly into 16 minutes. And I've learned how to use my new laptop to do these videos at last. And so this is me signing out, Debbie Nicholson, and I'll talk to you again next time. Bye.